Okay guys, in today's video I'll be doing an unboxing of the Samsung Galaxy S6, and this is the AT&T edition, which is black. Let me see if I get the camera to focus. And 32 GB. Take a look on the back panel, you will see some of the specs. Basically it's compatible with 4G LTE, 64-bit octa-core processor. You have a 5.1 quad HD super AMOLED display. I think that's Gorilla Glass 4, but we'll go into more into that. 16-megapixel rear camera with up to image stabilization, 5-megapixel front facing camera, wireless charging compatible, but it's going to require a charging pad, and it comes with Samsung Knox. And again, it's a 32 GB version Android operating system, which I think it's Android 5.0 or maybe 5.1, not sure, but we'll see more on the inside. Alright, so let's unbox the phone. Sorry for my video, I guess you're going to see a little shaking because I don't have a stand at the moment, so I'm trying my best to avoid it from shaking too much. So once again, it's the AT&T edition, so look at it. It comes with a plastic, and then I'm just gonna slide it out the box. Alright, so I'm gonna slide that out and get back to you. Now I've removed the plastic, and you could see that's the beautiful Samsung Galaxy S6. Take a look at the back panel here. Same, I think it's super AMOLED, Gorilla Glass 4 on the back, but the only thing, you get a lot of fingerprints because of the glassy finish and the aluminum body. Feels pretty good in the hand, but I'll get into that later on. Now I'm gonna take a look and see what's going on the inside of the box. Comes with a AT&T Quick Start guide, and then the manual is in this piece right here. Then we have a standard US charger. Let me see if I can get a better focus. Okay, as you can see, it has 9V and 5V. I think the 9V is for super quick charge or something like that, and the 5V is standard. Nice little adapter. You get your mini micro USB cable, 2.0. I don't know, for some reason Samsung step backwards with the 2.0 instead of using the 3.0 on the S6, but I guess they know the reason why they did all of that. Then you get your earphone, which it comes with, I think, 2 earbuds. And one is already pre-installed. Alright, so let's pull on the phone and see what's going on the inside. I think I probably might need to put it on the charger to get it come up. So what I'm gonna do is plug in the charger and get back to you. Okay, in the video I forgot to mention that it also comes with this pin for you to use to open the SIM tray to put in your micro SIM cards. So now that we have enough charge on the Samsung Galaxy S6, as I was saying earlier on during the unboxing, it tends to get a lot of fingerprints. So if you're a person who can deal with fingerprints, then you shouldn't have any problems. And if you're a person who can't deal with it, I guess you need to keep one of them soft rags to just wipe it off. At the back here, here's the 16-megapixel camera, LED flash. I think it probably have an heart rate sensor also, just like the previous S5. Volume rocker on the left, down, up, and the power button on the right. And there is the micro SD. Not micro SD, I mean a nano SIM, not America SIM. Charging port on the bottom, 3 millimeter audio earphone jack, and then there's a mic, and then the speaker. And basically looking at the design, it's pretty nice and maybe a luxurious device. And AT&T model will have the logo there. I think that's the same thing for all the US carrier. And the international version, I guess you just have the Samsung Galaxy S6 logo at the back. So let's put on the device. Okay, Samsung Galaxy S6 powered by Android. And that's the AT&T sound. So I'm gonna just turn it on Wi-Fi and just connect to the Wi-Fi network real quickly. I think the lighting condition kind of bad, so bear with me guys. So I'm just gonna run through this quickly, basically accepting the terms and be back. So in this unboxing, I won't be doing too in-depth review. I'm just doing the basic for all my fans out there who like Samsung. But I'm basically gonna be doing reviews on all different phones. I'm just downloading the AnTuTu benchmark. So for all my, I would say, all my phone geeks who are interested in benchmark scores, you're gonna see what the Samsung Galaxy S6 is like. Basically, the phone is extremely fast, no complaint. You probably might see some lags every now and again, but this is basically stock. There is no additional apps downloaded. Come out of the box with the AT&T, you're gonna get a lot of AT&T preloaded apps. So it comes with Amazon, a bunch of different apps. I guess they are partners with AT&T. You get Microsoft. I think you get like 100 gigabyte storage for free for 2 years with the cloud from Microsoft, which is pretty good because this phone doesn't carry micro SD. So if you are a person who tend to fully phone, you probably might need to go for a bigger storage or I guess transfer your stuff quickly to prevent the phone from being full. Let me take a look here and see what's going on. I think I've got an error while downloading the AnTuTu benchmark. So I'm just gonna try that again real quickly. So it's a pretty decent phone. Gonna talk about the camera. It comes with also Facebook and Instagram pre-installed. And let's see the camera. It's pretty good because at the moment I'm using my S5 to do this video. I mean the unboxing for the Samsung Galaxy S5. And the quality is pretty good. What I'm gonna do, I probably might do a quick video with the S5, not sure, and maybe put it in this video. But Samsung kind of squeezing a lot into the camera quality. It's pretty decent, and they try to get rid of this bunch of stuff pop up in the face. And the front facing camera should be pretty good. Let's see. So as you can see, that's me right there doing the video. The front facing camera, and it's pretty good. swipe to the left gives you a lot of, gives you some features like slow motion, fast video, etc. But it's well worth the money. So it comes with also SLT for those of you interested in being fit, which is pretty good. As soon as the Antutu benchmark is downloaded, what I'm gonna do for you guys is just to do the test. Next thing I would like to say is that, oh, the phone comes with 3 gigs of RAM and it's pretty fast with 3 gigs of RAM, so you could run a bunch of apps. It comes with Wi-Fi B, sorry, I would say A, B, G, N, and AC dual band, and Bluetooth version 4.1, NFC compatible, infrared. It comes with the infrared on top here, infrared blast, I would say, for controlling your television and so forth. Right now that the Antutu benchmark is finished, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start the test. You know, it's running, and this is 64-bit. I'll go into further details about the processor once I start the Antutu benchmark. So let's enable. I think it have to do unknown source, allow. Okay, install, accept, then, and then, so as you can see, that's a Samsung, just waiting on the camera to focus, Samsung SM-G920A, and that's the AT&T man. So let's start the test. Alright, so while the test is running there, I'm gonna talk about the processor in the device. It comes with Samsung own processor, which is the Exynos 7420, and that's quad core, which clocks at 1.5 gigahertz, and that's the big core, I'd say, and then the small core clock at, no, sorry, the small core clocks at 1.5 and the big core clocks at 2.1 gigahertz. And then here we have the score, and the score is 68,215. And that's a good decent score. I must say that the device tend to feel a little warm, and I'm currently in air condition and it feels a little warm. So I guess that's it for the unboxing. Once again, the score is 68,215. We're going to take a quick look in the settings. Up here is the notification here. You have different toggles. I notice Samsung has removed a little icon where you could touch and see, I guess, a bunch of them, but I guess you just put whatever you need up there. And let's take a look in the settings. There in the settings, it's Android 5.0, which is Lollipop, as you can see there. So that's a new Android operating system, and that's basically it. So if you guys want to get this device, feel free to just purchase one of, it's a pretty good device and good quality, different from previous generation where you get aluminum finish and Gorilla Glass 4. So thank you guys for watching, and please subscribe to my channel. Goodbye.